everyone. Today in this class we are going to start the new topic graphical representation of motion, and we will represent different types of motion using the graph. And students, in this chapter, in this topic, we will also discuss how you can reduce a very big problem or very large questions, problems into a small one using the graphical presentation. Students, first of all, let us discuss some basic graphical presentation. Students, we have the first graph which we are going to study. The first graph about which we are going to discuss is the displacement time graph. The first graph is the displacement time graph. Students, in displacement time graph, we are going to start to study how, in any type of motion, how displacement varies according to the time. There may be different types of variation. There may be uniform variation in displacement. There may be non-uniform variation in the displacement. Then we are going to discuss and we are going to identify these situations using the graph. Let us study. Suppose I have a graph like this. Students, in this graph you can see, in this graph the displacement is constant. Suppose displacement is 40 meter. You can see here, at the y axis we are considering the displacement and the x axis we are taking the time. Here you can see displacement is constant, and at every time displacement is same. At every time displacement is same, and this graph is representing the body at rest. This graph is representing the body at rest. Now, what about this graph? This is the time, and at y axis we are considering the displacement. What about this graph? In this graph, you can see the motion is like this. If you try to understand this graph, in this graph, students, you can see that the time is constant, time is fixed, and displacement is going on. But such type of graphs are impossible because, students, time cannot be at rest. Here you can see that the time is at rest, but we all know very well that the time never stops. Time will never at rest. Our third graph is, Mr. Student, this graph is not possible. Our third graph is time, displacement. Our third graph is like this. In this graph you can see, this graph is also not possible, because you can see at the same time here two positions, which is not possible. It is not possible at the same time you are in the school or in the home also. Then this graph gives that at the same time two positions are not possible, then this type of graph is also wrong. Our third graph is like this, time, displacement. This graph is representing a uniform velocity. This graph represents a body covers equal distance in equal interval of time, which we have studied in class 9th. Uniform velocity. If the graph is like this, suppose the graph is like this, in the curve shape, then it will give a non-uniform velocity. Then, by the different nature of the graph, by different the shape of the graph, we can identify the motions. Students, now let us discuss how you can do the calculation using the graph. Students, now we are going to perform some calculations using the graph. You can see, suppose you have a graph, this is the time, this is the displacement. And in this graph, your x-axis is the time and y-axis is the displacement. Suppose I have a graph like this. Students, to perform any type of calculation, first of all, we should identify that the graph is between these two variables. Identify these two variables, that the graph is drawn between these two variables, and here one variable is displacement and another is the time. Displacement and time. In second steps, find the relation between x and t. Students, between the displacement and time there is a relation. Velocity is equal to displacement upon time. Velocity is equal to displacement upon time. Students, now this is the formula of physics. We are going to attach this formula with this graph. Consider this angle is theta. This is x and this is t. If this value is x, this will also be the x. If this is x, then this is also the x. Students, from this graph, from this triangle, find the value of tan theta. You all know tan theta is equal to perpendicular upon base. Here perpendicular is x and base is t. Perpendicular upon base. Perpendicular is x and base is t. Students, you can see that the tan theta of this graph is equal to the velocity. You can see the right hand side of both are the equal. This is also x by t, this is also x by t. Means from this graph you identify the tan theta, which is also known as slope of the graph. Then this slope will give the velocity. Then students, always remember, if the relation between these two quantities, means between x and y, is a ratio, then always find the slope of the graph. If relation between this x and y is a ratio, then always find the slope of the graph. Students, I have few examples. Suppose this is the time, this is the displacement, and the graph is this. Students, you can see here in this graph there is no slope, because we want to calculate velocity, and velocity is equal to displacement upon time. Here displacement upon time you have, and I have told you that if the relation is in the form of ratio, then always find the slope of the graph. Slope is tan theta. And since this graph has no slope, this is parallel to this time axis, and slope is zero, hence velocity is also equal to the zero. Second example, you can take another example. Suppose you have a graph of this shape. Here this is origin, this is A, B and C. Suppose if I am asking the velocity OA, the velocity AB and the velocity BC, then how you will calculate these velocities? To find out these velocities, students, what will do? Suppose the values which are given here, the time is, this is 2 seconds, this is 4 seconds and this is 8 seconds, and here this is 200 meter. Now I want to calculate the velocity OA. Since velocity is equal to displacement upon time, and this is a displacement upon time, which is a ratio, and for ratio always calculate the slope of the graph, and this is equal to the displacement is 200, perpendicular upon base 200, and time is 2. You will get the answer 100 meter per second. VAB, and you can see here there is no slope of this graph. The slope is 0, then the VAB will be 0. At this time body is at rest. And to calculate the slope of this graph, students, always remember the angle should be taken anti-clockwise from the horizontal. Then we will take this angle, not this. This angle is ought to be taken. Okay? Then if we calculate this value, this slope will be just equal to the perpendicular upon base, but there will be a negative sign. And that is equal to the perpendicular, which is 200, and base of this angle is 4, to it is the 4. This is the 40 meter per second. Now students, in this way we can calculate the any type of velocity using displacement time graph. find using the slope of the graph. Okay, then see, in our next class we'll start from the velocity time graph and acceleration time graph, and so many numericals are also there. Okay, thank you students, sir. Thank you students for watching.